My name is Sonali Dadoo. My advisor was Dr. Ken Barbie, and I'm concentrating in biomaterials and tissue engineering in the School of Biomedical Engineering, Science, and Health Systems. So I think I was most interested in this program because I'm majoring in biomedical engineering, but I'm also a pre-med student, and I felt like this co-op was a great way to combine both of those interests because you get to shadow physicians, sort of get those kind of clinical hours, interact with patients, and forge your own way in the hospital while also coming back to Drexel and using the like engineering design project skills that we've learned. So I worked with primarily Dr. Vina and Ed Carney. He works in the pediatric ICU at CHOP. During the first week, he sort of acquainted me with the space and introduced me to a couple doctors. But after that, most of my experience at CHOP was pretty much me using those connections that he initially made and finding more and more experiences for myself. So I did have a project. It was primarily based in the neonatal intensive care unit, and it was called a neonatal nasal cannula fixation device. And so I initially chose this project just kind of in passing when I was observing patients. I noticed that their nasal cannula kept falling out of their nose, and the young babies didn't really know what was going on, and so they kept crying, and the nurses would come by and they'd have to keep adjusting the cannula back in their face. And the main issue is that these patients are in the hospital for 1 or 2 years, for very long periods of time, and to have a nasal cannula that they use every day just consistently fall out is a really big problem. After I noticed the problem, I talked to nurses and even some of the patient parents, because it is a pediatric hospital, so the parents are just as involved as the patients themselves, who also agreed that this was a really big issue. So then I brought it back to Drexel, and we kind of, I talked to my advisor, and we figured out that this project would be feasible in the 9-month time frame of senior design with the budget that we had and the other constraints. So that's how we decided to go forward with it. So we actually ended the 9 months with a prototype that we were able to test and that passed all of our verification testing. So we have a functional prototype of a device that you can put on a baby's face and that secures the cannula against the pulling forces that they might experience in the ICU. I was most surprised by the autonomy of it. I didn't really know what to expect. And after, you know, the first week, they really just kind of let us pave our own path, which was really interesting because there's so many resources at the hospital, and to just have one connection really brings you into an entire 6-month experience where you can experience all the different areas of the hospital and all the different clinicians and patients that work there.